We will discuss a bit about organizational capability building. How does an individual or an organization go about building the capability so that the organization is sustainable in the future and is ready for the future challenges? Now, I've seen several cuts and iterations and takes of senior management on this. Fundamentally, speaking, every organization, when we are talking of building the capability of an organization, the capability of the organization needs to be built at two levels. First is current level and the next level. Often, I have seen confusion existing at this itself. So what I mean to say here is that what is the current level of capability required in the company to be able to meet the levels of operations or business performance which they want. To meet this, what is required at various roles, at more often at the critical roles. That's always the focus. Now the next level is the organization is obviously growing. So when an organization grows and it has got a strategic plan for the future, it's important to know that what is the level of expertise, which is needed for the to take the strategic plans forward. So what is the level of expertise that will be required? What is the capability today? And therefore, what is the capability which is needed to be built? Now, it's very important to understand the difference in these two and not confuse. So while the current level is all about raising the floor, the next level is all about sustainability of the organization. So it's, now if you see, both of these are extremely strategic in nature. So the organization therefore needs to have a very strategic perspective to L&D, to capability building. Let me not call it L&D, because L&D has become quite a department and a cliched word now. Now, what kind of capability building should be therefore done? Now, capability building, again, if you're talking of raising the floor, first is raising the floor or sustaining in future. So if you're talking of raising the floor, what we need to look at is that what are the critical roles? What are the capabilities needed at different levels of those particular roles? You know, as and when, see, the person just by designating him as an vice president doesn't start displaying the capabilities and the competencies required of a vice president. So therefore, the roles, the capabilities needed, the gap assessment for the individual, and then building, capability building or capability development plan. Yeah, so that is the sequence in and executed to perfection. You know, very often I've seen that capability development plans are not executed to perfection, and the management commitment to capability development is very low. The next bit of it is, when you're talking of the next level, here understand that it's even a larger shift for the individual. So here again, for going to the next level, what are the critical capabilities required? Now, can I have all the roles? Can I know the critical roles? Maybe not, but fundamental capabilities required. And then how do you, build, do the gap assessment? Not so much needed at that stage, but still it's good to know where you stand. And after doing the gap assessment, then you develop capability. Now, for example, an organization which has largely grown through internal funds accrual route and by operations. Now, if they decide that they want to go into the merger and acquisition space and they want to acquire some companies. Now that is here. So the organization doesn't have capability, they will have to develop the capability and will have to build themselves over time. Now what is here is that say an organization is doing business which is of a medium scale perspective. So they are 300 Indian rupees, 300 Indian rupees, 300 crores of Indian rupees organization, a mid scale. Now suddenly someone has got very interested, that's a good business opportunity, so people, there is an infusion of funds and it becomes a, it has got a huge infusion of capital and now it has the potential to become a 2000 crore Indian rupees industry. So from a mid cap, from a middle space, it becomes a large company. This requires a different capability altogether. Similarly, this requires a different capability altogether. Now the important thing is that who can drive this change? Very often in organizations they have L&D departments, quite often not strategic in nature but operational in nature, reporting to the HR heads who themselves perhaps not have a very good clue of what's happening and are operational and are busy fighting and finding people. And then they expect this person out here with low budgets available for development and do a bunch of training programs and develop the capability. I think that's a very shoddy plan. It's a very shoddy plan when you look at the requirement of the next level and requirement of the next level, current level and the next level. So therefore organization capability building needs to be very, very seriously done, not confused with talent management fundamentally, and organization capability building needs to have a strategic focus. It has to be realized that and the building of individual capability would require a bunch of support like education, of course, then exposure, of course, and on top of it you might also have experiences, a lot of different diverse experiences. And it is a continuous process. There is a need for budding, there is a need for coaching, there is a need for serious thinking on this plane. So my take on this is that organization capability building is a very, very serious activity and it needs to be given that kind of a clout in the organization and that kind of seriousness. Organizations which have seriously built on capability have their own research framework models and do very well on that. So look at your organizational capability building model. If you sincerely feel that if you are ready for the current level that you want or the next level, and if both the gaps are there, and which most likelihood is there in one, some of the companies that I have seen and worked closely with, that's time for you to reassess the way you're doing the work. Ensure that you've got a great head of L&D who can understand the current level and the next level, not someone who's shunted and put into that role or someone who's going to retire after a few years. Ensure that there's a very, very active and aligned to the strategy of the organization, current as well as future, and systematically build the capability of the organization. It doesn't take too long a time. Yes, sincere effort it needs.